It all started when I was a young kid of 6 years old. I was playing at my grandma's house, and she discovered every week she would be like cleaning the house and have those really big buckets full of water, but it was always leaking. And she was like, what is happening here? And all of a sudden she found out that I was upstairs collecting all these buckets in front of me and just setting them up. Because I saw at the time there was like a pop TV program where I saw Stuart Copeland playing drums, and I saw every other band playing, and I was like really enthusiastic about how they played. So I would put some music on, put the buckets in front of me, and start just like playing around on those buckets, and then collect them again and put them away where my grandma had her buckets. So she ended up like seeing me doing this. Then one of my uncles discovered it, and he told my father, maybe it's time to buy him just like a little drum kit so he can explore his talent or his maybe his energy, because I was a kid full of energy, playing around, wild. And so they did. And I started playing when I was 6 years old. At the end of almost by 12, I got my really big first drum kit. So that's how it all happened. I was a lucky guy. By the time I was 12, I went to see a teacher in the neighborhood, and he taught me to play along with some music. He would put the records on, would explain me the grooves, how to play them, and then showed it like, oh, listen to the music, and this is how you play it on top of the music, which was very helpful later on when I was getting older, and especially doing this professional job right now. So I went on to visit this guy called Koen van Duffel, who became my mentor. In the beginning, he showed me like, okay, this is how you read music. This is how you do the technique on drums, and especially the discipline behind it. Very important. And that's what I discovered later. And of course, I was a young guy, so he needed to motivate me a lot, which he did, because he would put some music on as well, but he wrote it down so I could read it, play along, and I would exactly know how the grooves were going. So it was like a new world going open. Maybe I was like by the time about 18, so it's a long time in between there with those two teachers. He advised me like, maybe you should go further. So I went on to go to this professional drum school Kleuver in Holland, because we never had a drum school. I mean, you had schools in Belgium, but never like professional minded people who were only busy drumming. So I went on to go to Holland, to Haag, to go to the school, met this guy Kleuver, and even he was more like into the professionality of musicians. I know like a lot of famous drummers in Holland right now who went to the school, and especially to Kleuver, the guy himself. He was very precise, and he was very, sometimes he was very arrogant, but he made sure, his first question, for instance, was, what do you want to do? What do you want to become? You want to become an amateur? You want to become semi-professional drummer or a professional drummer? And of course, as a young guy, I was like, I want to be a professional. And he said, well, go and study. And he was, I mean, he was like, I was really afraid of him, because he was really strict. He would say, he would come in and say, so did you study? I would say, yes. And he'd be like, I can hear you didn't. Go back, get in your car, drive home, and be back next week and make sure you know what you're doing. Which, of course, helped me, because I was so furious, I was so angry. But it helped me in a way, because I was doing and I wanted to do it, and I definitely wanted to make sure he was happy with what I was doing. So I did that for a couple of years. Dom Famularo was one of the most inspiring people I've ever met. I was lucky enough to meet him at a masterclass we were doing at our drum school. And I met him, and he was open, and he was like showing me all these techniques and everything. And he was very enthusiastic in approaching people and telling everyone the knowledge of every technique and drumming, and so positive. So at the end of the masterclass, he said to me, why don't you come to America? Why don't you come to New York and study with me? And I was so happy, because I was like, wow, I was going home telling my parents, man, I want to go to New York. And my parents were like, what do you want to do in New York? Study drums with this guy, Dom Famularo. And they were like, okay, if you think that's going to help you, you make sure you have the money to go, and then you go, because you're old enough, so you go. So I was playing in a cover band at the time, and I was like playing a lot, and I really took all my money, put it on the side to make sure I could go to Dom Famularo. I think it took me a year. I was able to go to Dom. I had the money, all was set. He set up like a whole like a schedule of lessons with Jim Chapin, Larry Levine, and Charles Perry. And I could go. So I went to New York and see Dom Famularo. And I was so happy. I was so happy, because the first thing he said to me, he was like, okay, from now on, we're stop using one word. I don't forget it. And he would say, you're never going to use the word problem again. And you change it into challenge. I didn't understand the word, what he was saying. But by his positive way of talking and everything he did, I was really into everything he was telling me. I was so focused. And up till today, he's one of the guys as my second mentor, together with Koen van Duffel, who I always call when I'm having a sort of thing I need to think of, or a technique that doesn't work out, or anything else. Even with stuff I'm doing right now, like writing a children's book, I'm calling him and saying, I want your view on it, over it. And I was like, all these things are so good and making you realize how important people are in your life. He helped me a lot by the way of thinking, the way of being, not only as a musician, but as a human being as well. And still, till today, I think about it, which I think I'm very happy with that. So Dom Famularo, Koen van Duffel, very important people in my life. What did I do? What am I doing? It's a lot of stuff. I used to teach a lot. I used to play in cover bands. I used to do sessions, like recording sessions for other people. But now I'm mainly doing Trigger Finger. I produce a lot of bands. I'm writing some scores for films. Before that, I was a hired musician for Hooverphonic, recorded albums for Arno, Milo, you name it. Went on to record albums in Italy for people over there. And this is in a shell. This is something which I looked up to, and still one of my all-time favorite drummers. They all kind of like doing sessions, playing with their bands and producing a lot, or writing. And I'm loving it and I'm enjoying it. And I hope I can still do it when I'm 81, maybe older, who knows. Inspiration you get from not only from music, but you get from everything, I think. It sometimes, of course, comes from music because you're always busy with music, especially me. But I discovered, just recently, I discovered when I was on holiday, I was into a sort of a mode where I didn't know what I was liking musically. And I went to go to Barcelona on a trip, on a holiday trip, and I found out there were like three exhibitions who blew my mind. And I never thought like an exhibition or some art or whatever could help me out. But hey, I discovered it again. I was like, yeah, of course, anything can inspire you. Of course, drummers, because one of my all-time favorite drummers is still Jim Keltner. It's Matt Chamberlain, but it's also like, there's so many, of course, it's Keith Moon or John Bonham, you name it, or Elvin Jones, or whatever. And it depends, because sometimes you would put records on where they are playing on, but then on the other hand, it's like new drummers coming along and you see them playing and be like, wow, this is great too. So, but besides that, I mean, you get inspired by maybe seeing a singer, and maybe even your own bandmates, because in these days when we're releasing our new album, I found out like Ruben, our singer, is a big influence, because he would talk about music, or our bass player Paul would talk about music, and you kind of like make it around, like you inspire all three of you, and that's beautiful, I guess. Even by walking along and seeing by the trees, like, wow, what is this? This is beautiful. And it might be like you come back and you'd be like, man, this is inspiring me. This is just, it blew my mind. And I think the positive reaction on those things is inspiration for everything you do. Doesn't matter what you do. Being healthy is very important, obviously, but it's not always easy to go on tour and find right food. But I'll try to manage it. And sometimes, you know, you become a little bit more like this, and then you go back to this. And then I think, oh, I need to work out. And then I go running, and I hate running. But you go running, and I'm fucking really like fucked up in your head. But at the end of it, I recently found something which I really love to do, and it's just like walking. I go out every morning and I walk for maybe 5 miles, 6 miles, and then I enjoy it a lot. It's not slowly, but it's on a good tempo, which makes me feel comfortable, And I come back and I feel really good. And then I'll try to make sure I'm not eating only junk food, which I love, by the way. But, and I'll try to manage not to drink too much. But again, if you're on the road, it doesn't work. But one other thing I need to mention, and which is very important in this topic, which I got from Dom Familaro. You need to have a lot of sex. To be honest, a lot of time when people ask me to do clinics, I'm really scared. I feel what's in there in the place where I'm at, and then I know I want to tell you or tell the people more about how to approach music instead of showing off the techniques I have. Because I think there are better players who can do that than myself. I obviously start a drum clinic very easy with putting some music on. And tell everyone, hey, listen, we're all drummers. My point of view is what we want to show to the people when you're playing a gig or making a record is to make sure people can shake their asses off or jump around and feel it instead of showing what you can do on a drum set, is my point of view. So clinics, it's something weird. It always messes in my head. But if I put the music on, for instance, like a Bo Diddley groove, and I tell people, hey drummers, show me how you can dance. I think that's quite funny to see how drummers cannot dance. Get my heart.